nine-lane bridge. You have the right of way. Yeah, you can go around by that.
To the front there?
You can just pull in here anywhere. This is Tortilla Flat, where we're going to do a driver swap before we hit the off-road portion. Just pull over anywhere. I guess the cones down there, they may have that marked off for us. Well, we're here at Tortilla Flat for driver change, potty stop. Give you a little shot of the landscape here. Shifting and clear sight.
Well, the benefit here, most of all, is that you have a better vision. Let's say you have better opportunity to brake downshifting, and of course to see how the car react. It's really amazing, this car in this condition. And trying to push as hard as I can in tight corners, especially using second gear, and the handling of the car is wonderful, wonderful. Really, it's a pleasure to drive in this condition with this car.
Great, thank you. Now, it's interesting, I'm sitting here in the back seat, and as you can see, the camera is, you know, just bouncing around a little bit, but I'm pretty... The ride back here is pretty smooth.
Is that right?
Yeah, the ride's pretty smooth. This is a rough road. It's unpaved. We're up here. Ooh, that's kind of bouncy, as you can see. But we're up here in the mountains, and if you can see out over the horizon there, we're pretty high. I don't know what the elevation is. I think yesterday we were as high as about 4,000 feet. But I haven't seen an elevation sign for this particular mountain. missed that turn.
What I'm doing with this car, I can't do it with another. Another.
Here comes the truck.
Gosh, this is wonderful.
Oh boy. Not much room for passing.
Yeah.
Oncoming traffic.
Yeah.
Here we have no guardrail, folks. You missed that one. It's a long first step. Long first step. Another hard day. Hard day's work at the office, right? Yeah, like I said, I'm surprised the suspension on this thing is really nice.
Yeah.
We're hitting some nice little potholes in this non-paved road going down the mountain.
Deep, you know.
And it's not bouncing you around. It's really not beating you up. You don't feel like you've been in a washing machine. I'm being tossed a little bit from side to side because as a passenger, you can't anticipate the turns, and so you will get thrown around a little bit. Whereas the driver knows what's coming next, so they can brace themselves. We just tried to pass, had a camper here on it. As you can see, it was a very tight turn. A very tight pass, rather, because the road isn't that wide. And it also doesn't help when you have small rocks that have fallen off the mountain onto the roadway. So it's interesting.
The mass flat area, but in the corners it's impossible because that's what everybody break, and there are a lot of holes.
Yeah,
you know, and that's why the suspension has to work extra, and that's why you see the, you know, sometimes like a ABS gang.
Yeah,
gang.
Chattering.
Right.
I want you to catch this view off to the right. We're going across this little one-lane bridge. And I don't know how long we're going to be here. It won't be long, but oh, you can't see it. The camera's not set up right. But anyway, nice view. Another one-lane bridge. I guess there are a lot of those up here. We're coming up on another one.
Another one.
I think I should let the viewers know that this is a very, very bumpy road, and we did bottom out a couple times. I'm not going to say that we didn't, but we did bottom out a couple times because of the speed, and the bump was well, the pothole was a little deeper than anticipated. But we didn't damage anything. We're gaining on Gary. He's leaving a nice dust trail. It's getting heavier and heavier. We're getting closer and closer. Pretty soon, folks, there he is. You see an XC70 in front of us. Emilio caught him. Slide there. I'm glad you're driving the stretch and not me. I'd be all over the place. I would be everywhere. He wants you to pass. Go ahead and pass. He gave up. Bye, Gary. That mountain shot. Now, video with this kind of intense driving without you losing your concentration and out going over the edge here, do you get tired? Your arms getting tired?
No. I'm fine. Because, again, one of the problems that you get tired, especially your shoulders, is because you don't have the right position in the seat.
Okay.
But if you're familiar with put your hands in the steering wheel before driving, you're okay.
Yeah, I don't want you to break your concentration on these roads. Because it could be the last time. Now, this stretch of the road is like the washboard that they would have on a test track where the bumps are right in succession. So, and as you can see, the camera is not bouncing around that much. So, and again, sitting in the passenger seat, I'm not being bounced all over the place. Okay. I'm not being tossed up and down or from side to side. Pretty, the car is very stable, as well as Emilio is doing a great job of driving this baby. Are we getting a little rear end slide through some of these curves? Do you feel it sliding a little bit?
Yes, but the reason for that, right? The reason for that is that I want to push a little bit to the limit in order to see how it slide and how I can control the situation.
Okay.
So, I'm doing the curves. Sliding and pushing, you know.
Oh, the car in front of us.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, well, this, okay. And it's not a Volvo.
Exactly. And see, the reason that now we are so bumping is because we are going slow.
Right.
But if we, you know, we keep the speed, it would be easier.
Now look at the wheels on that.
Yeah.
Oh, we missed it. Look at that. The wheels chatter.
Gotcha. He has a nerve because...
Yeah, he's going from side to side. Okay, he's going to let us pass. Thank you. Nice flying turn. Another blind.
Blind.
Whoa. Mm-hmm. Gee.
High and narrow.
Yes. Good grief.
over there.
Here we have the Roosevelt Dam. We finally made it. I told you I'd get you here, folks. There it is. Coming to the end of our road trip. You've been on the road with Roosevelt and Emilio. We're in the 2012 Volvo XC70 and hope you enjoyed the trip. I know we did. It's been great. As always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time.